once the most well-known and highest-paid African-American concert singer in the United States, yet today few people remember the name Sissieretta Jones. A new biography about this famed opera and concert diva seeks to bring her the recognition she deserves. And joining us this morning is the author, Maureen Lee. Good morning, Maureen.
Good morning.
So tell us about Sissieretta Jones. Who is she for those who aren't familiar?
Well, Sissieretta Jones was born in Portsmouth, Virginia in 1868, and she and her family moved to Rhode Island in 1876, and when she was about 7 years old. And she just started singing in Providence churches. And she got well known, and she got a big break and went off to the West Indies and started singing. But she wasn't known in the United States till about 1892. She sang at Madison Square Garden, and almost overnight she became famous. And later on in her career, she sang at Carnegie Hall, she sang in opera halls all over the United States and Canada, and she was just so well known, she was called the greatest singer of her race.
Wow.
And she was likened to a white opera star, Adelina Patti, and they called her the Black Patti.
Oh, wow.
Yeah.
So she was very well known. So what sparked your interest to write this book about Sissieretta?
Well, in 2003, Rhode Island had the Rhode Island Treasures, and they had an exhibit about Sissieretta. And I first heard about her, and I thought, here I am, a Rhode Islander, and I have never heard about this woman who was supposedly so famous and came long before Marian Anderson. Mm-hmm. And I thought, something needs to be done. So I was getting ready to retire, and I took this on as my retirement project, and it's taken me 9 years, but the University of South Carolina is going to publish my book on May the 15th.
Wow, this is incredible. Your own book there, it's a big accomplishment for you. What do you hope that readers will take away from this?
I hope they will come to understand the pioneer that Sissieretta was, that she had all kinds of limitations and obstacles because of her race, of course, during this time. But she didn't let that stop her. She had a dream, she wanted to sing, and she had to find ways to work through things, but she was able to achieve her dream.
Well, we wish you the best of luck with this book, as much as Sissieretta had with her career. So, Maureen, thank you so much for coming
in. Thank you.
And can
I tell you one thing, too?
The
Rhode Island Black Heritage Society is going to have a big book event for me May 11th or 12th, and you'll be hearing more about that.
Okay, excellent. And the book is Sissieretta Jones, the Greatest Singer of Her Race. It's available now.